it's your time, showtime. And for you, I wish I had more time. Red wine, chocolate, baby, you could be my Valentine. More than just sex, let's change, baby. So you DJ,
it will.
Hey girl, so glad that I found you. Tell your friends.
What's up, honey gang? It's your girl Jazz, and today we're talking about marriage roadblocks. So before we get into this video, make sure you guys like,
subscribe,
and share this
video.
Yes, thank you. With anybody, everybody, to let them know what your girls are doing on this channel. Make sure if you guys are new,
shut your mouth. If you guys are new, we're parents.
Welcome.
Sorry.
Yeah. And welcome to the Honey Gang family.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
So stay tuned, you guys. We're going right in. Okay, welcome back, you guys.
Welcome back.
So the first thing we're talking about is roadblocks in a marriage. Everybody has their specific roadblock in their personal situations that can strain a relationship. So the first question we have is what, Ellie?
How long have you been married?
How long have you been married?
How long have I been married?
Mm-hmm. How long have
I been married for 10 years.
10 years. Did you have roadblocks?
No, I mean, when we first got together, we was really young.
How old?
I was like 17, and he was like,
around the same age. Around the same age. And was there a roadblock?
I had Tati.
Okay. So
yeah, becoming a mother was not the roadblock. What was the roadblock was getting used to having a kid and still being young.
And just got married.
And just got married. So it was like, yeah, all of those in one go.
Right, right. I am going on 1 year being married, and the roadblock for me would be, I already had a child previously, so it was mostly letting my guard down and letting a man play the role of the house, you know, like what it's supposed to be. And then we had more children, and now we have no space in our bedroom.
Yeah.
So the roadblock is there's no quality time.
Yeah, and if there's no quality time, I think
nobody's happy.
Yeah, I think sometimes you lose sight on y'all.
Yeah.
And I think that date night is a mandatory. Y'all need that time.
Some people say that you have to be selfish a little bit. I find that very hard for me to be selfish and have the quality time, because I'm always in mommy mode. Always.
That's true.
The only time I'm not in mommy mode is maybe when it's time for us to go to sleep. Oh, but don't let me hear somebody coughing or their asthma acting up. I'm up
and
involved.
You need to get on this machine?
Yes, up all night. So there's really no quality time. What's the next question we got? I can't really.
I think you answered it. It was, what is your current roadblock? Don't judge us. We didn't have no paper, and it was like spur of the moment. So we were like,
the current roadblock is everybody's gotten a little bit older, but the last one is still in our bed, so I still have to deal with somebody in my bed.
I mean, my current roadblock is, well, our continuing roadblock would be that we have both sets of parents in the house. So when we're not tending to our children, you know, we're making sure everybody else is okay too.
Right.
And then we put our relationship last, mm-hmm, which is also the,
you can wait. Mommy duties. See what I'm saying? Y'all can wait. That makes perfect sense. That could play a role also.
Yeah.
What was it?
You want me to smack you? I'm not going to ask you again.
What's the next question?
Were there always roadblocks there?
I'm going to say there was always roadblocks for me, but I do take partial blame.
What do you mean? Why was there roadblocks always there before the kid? Well, for you, it's a little different because you already had Mari, but...
Right.
Why?
I don't know. I just...
Besides Mari.
What you mean besides Mari?
Because that's a roadblock, but...
Because if I didn't have a child, I think I would be a little bit more free. But because I have a child, I have to be still more precautious and more on top of. So I felt like if I was with, when I got with my husband now, yes, I knew I wanted to be married in a long-term relationship, but I still felt that uncomfortability of just if he said something or had to get on Kamari about something, I'll feel so defensive and be in mommy mode. And that's the huge transition, you know, like that's a big transition. I don't care. I personally feel like you've been a single parent
move
for however many years, and then you know you finally settle down. There is some adjustments behind meshing your child and your significant other together. You know, it's going to take some time. In my case,
yeah. I mean, I get it. All of my kids are from my husband, so I currently don't have that issue.
Was that a slug?
Oh no.
That was too funny. I currently don't have those issues. So as far as the roadblocks that we have currently, right? Mm-hmm. How are we addressing it and trying to, you know, change it?
I mean, Jose and I have been doing a lot more him and I. So if it's secret rendezvous, right? What?
You want a view?
Secret rendezvous. Mm-hmm. Rather it's going out to eat, sitting in a car, whatever the case may be. I cannot talk today.
It's okay.
I said whatever the face may be.
It's what? Okay. It's just me rubbing off.
Whatever the case may be, as long as we can have just a moment to ourselves, you know, maybe not in our house or in our bedroom, outside of the house, then we try to tackle that ASAP. Because we do know that if we don't tend to us, everything else is not gonna, you know, we are the pilots of this plane. My plane, my household. If that don't run right,
I like that.
We all going out.
For me, how I'm trying to break it, the cycle. Okay, so I'm always communicative, but I'm trying to articulate in the better way.
Articulate in a better way, meaning not being so rude.
Not being so blunt. Mm-hmm. Okay. Why does blunt? I don't consider blunt as being rude.
I don't either.
But I have to understand that being in a relationship, being married, that there's just a certain way you have to talk to your significant other. So, yes, I do talk like this. However, the biggest thing is maybe thinking 3 or 4 times before I say something, because the first initial response is going to sound,
yeah.
Then the second one might sound a little sarcastic. So the third one would be like, okay, bae, you know, this and this and this. Mm-hmm. So communicating properly. Debating without feeling like I have to win. You know what I mean? That's where I'm at. Oh, you're so proud, best friend.
I'm so proud.
Yes, I've been doing this work, you know what I'm saying? And it's been so hard. Well, we should ask the husbands to do like their little piece. we'll be surprised about what they'll say.
Yeah.
They'll probably glorify everything.
So,
okay, so we tackled what's the marriage roadblock for us, and we have different relationships, different situations. We talked about have there always been roadblocks in the marriage, and how do we fix that? So that is what we addressed today, you guys. If you are in a long-term marriage, if you're in a long-term relationship and you're not married,
yeah,
comment down below on your roadblocks.
Yeah, what's your roadblocks? You know, tell me how y'all getting through it.
We could probably have some similarities, and we just abbreviated it real quick for you guys.
Yeah, just a little quick little video, a little touch up.
Yeah, touch up. Touch the comment section. Comment down below, you guys, if you guys like this video. Thumbs up this video. Share this video with anybody and everybody.
Everybody.
Make sure you hit the notification bell to be notified our next upload. And if you can, if you already have not done so, subscribe to your girls and become a Honey Gang member with us. Woo! And baby, we're going to give it to you as... fun and real at the same time. Okay, so stay tuned, you guys. God bless you guys. See you next time.
Have a great weekend.